Hello dear students, today we will study another thermal analysis technique, which is differential thermal analysis. So this technique is similar with TSC, which we learned previously, which is differential scanning calorimetry. So in DTA, sample and reference are heated at same rate during the heating process, and any temperature difference between the sample and reference is recorded. So if you remember from my previous lecture, which is DSC, that we have two pans having separate heaters, and these heaters are connected to computer. And if there is some extra material, which is our sample in our reference pan and one is sample pan, if we put something in our sample pan, this material is extra, and if it absorbs it, the heater beneath that pan has to work more. But if there is some exothermic, it releases it, the heater beneath the sample pan become happy because it did not work a lot. So in this technique, we will only measure the difference of temperature. Suppose if we have one sample and one reference, and in sample pan we have our sample, and in reference pan we will put some inert material, the change or the difference in the temperature is recorded through this technique. Differential thermal analysis is a technique in which the temperature of the substance under investigation is compared with the temperature of a thermally inert material. We will use a thermally inert material in our reference pan, which will not absorb or emit heat. The differential temperature is plotted against time or against temperature. If there is no heat difference, if there is no difference of temperature between the sample and reference material during the heating process, then we can say that the sample does not undergo any chemical or physical change. So if you see that the temperature of both pans and the temperature difference is not changing, we can say that there is no physical or chemical change in the sample pan, because for every sample there must be a reaction which may be exothermic or endothermic. If there is exothermic, then we have increase in temperature in the sample pan. If it is endothermic, we see that temperature will decrease. So I will give you one example, that if you have beaker, and in the beaker if there is some exothermic reaction going on, you feel that the beaker is hot. But if there is some endothermic reaction going inside the beaker, it takes the heat from the environment and you feel that the beaker is cold. Okay, it is the same case. If your sample have some exothermic properties, there will be increase in temperature. But if there is some endothermic process, then you will feel there is decrease in temperature. If there is any chemical or physical change occur, there must be a temperature difference between sample and reference. So if the heat is emitted by the sample during the analysis, these type of reaction are known as exothermic reaction, such as phase transition, freezing, crystallization. You have to watch my previous video for these types. The temperature of the sample pan is higher than that of the reference pan because sample is emitting heat, okay, and you feel that the temperature is increasing in the sample pan. If the heat is absorbed by the sample during the analysis, these types of reaction are known as endothermic reactions, such as melting or dehydration of the sample, and mainly physical. The temperature of the sample pan is lower than that of the reference pan because it is absorbing heat. So if it takes the heat from the surrounding and also from your heater, and the temperature of the pan is not rising. So what you will see in the DTA curve, it is similar with the DSC curve. So you have exothermic and you have endothermic, and if your sample absorbs the heat, you will see a dip in the peak. And this is endothermic peak, absorbs heat. And if you see exothermic reaction, you will see a peak, sharp peak in the graph. So you have endo and exothermic on your x-axis and temperature or time on your y-axis. So this is typical, or you can say ideal DTA curve, which you normally see during your analysis. So you have endothermic peaks or exothermic peak. So if we talk about the instrument looks like similar with your DSC experiment. So you have one sample pen, one reference pen, and this is furnace which controls the temperature, and you have one atmosphere control. This is used for the gases. So you have to also introduce or purge nitrogen, which is also an inert gas, to remove any other oxygen or any other gas which can react or which can increase the temperature of the furnace, and then you can record it through micro recorder. So sample holder, sample and reference pan are usually metallic, aluminium, platinum, with or without lid. So you have to use inert material, of course. Best results are obtained when the area of contact between the sample and the pan is maximized. So you have to increase the surface area actually. So you have to place your sample on the surface of the pan. You have to not make a V shape. Samples are generally in 1 to 10 milligram range for analytical applications. The dimension of two pan must be identical. So it is not the case that one sample pan and one you have reference pan, and the radius or the diameter, if you think about the furnace, it will in their ideal location. Okay, it is not that reference pan is near to the furnace and the sample pan is little bit away from the furnace. Okay, it must be in same direction. Okay, if reference material used, then its waste must be identical to the sample. Okay, if you use any material, any sample, the weight of the inert material should be identical with your sample. And now we have furnace, the sample and reference should be arranged symmetrically with the furnace so that they are both heated and cooled in an identical manner. So this is very important. Sensor and recording system, a pair of thermocouple is used. One pair is in contact with the sample and the other pair is in contact with the reference. The output of the differential thermocouple TS minus TR, temperature of your sample minus temperature reference, or delta T, change in temperature, is amplified and sent to the data acquisition center. Platinum or chromium thermocouple are mostly used. The difference in temperature between the sample and the reference to be recorded as a function of either the sample temperature, the reference temperature, or time. So if we talk about the application of DTA, it is the fingerprints of various substances. You know, fingerprint, that every person in the world has some different fingerprint. So every material is also have different physical or chemical properties. The melting point of almost all the compound, all the chemicals are different from each other. So you can study the fingerprints of various chemicals. Study the characteristic of polymeric material, same like DSC. It will show melting curve, crystallization, and glass transition. Quality control of drugs. You can know the melting point, crystallinity, amorphous forms of different drugs. Quality control of simmer, soil, gas, etc. Because you can also check the exothermic and endothermic nature of these substances. Determination of heat of reaction, specific heat and energy changes, like heat capacity. So when we have this glass transition, it shows the heat capacity of your material. So thank you very much for your attention. And if you have any question, you can ask. Thank you very much.